When you're practically as old as the universe, you have to have some kind of hobby to keep from getting bored.
Who's ready to play?
Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we will explore the comic book origins of the Grand Master. Before we begin, we publish new videos every day, so be sure to subscribe for more great content. As with most comic book characters, there are often reimaginings and different versions to a character's past. We've chosen to primarily follow the storyline which unfolded in 1969's Avengers numbers 69 to 71, which was expanded upon in 1978's Avengers number 174, 1982's Contest of Champions number 1, and 1987's Silver Surfer number 4. The Grandmaster's shtick can be summed up in one word: games. The dude is only happy when he's playing some sort of whacked out game for outrageous stakes, as one of the elders of the universe, who's been around since just after the Big Bang. He's got years of experience perfecting this craft. On top of that, his super intellect and his ability to access something called the Power Primordial, which he uses to control life and death, also makes him rather formidable. Not a lot was revealed about the Grandmaster in his first appearance, way back in 1969, that is. In this tale, the Avengers were kidnapped by Kang the Conqueror, a villain from Earth's future. It turns out that a year ago, Kang had been mourning the loss of his beloved Ravonna when a strange figure appeared on his ship. This figure was none other than the Grandmaster, who challenged him to a game. If Kang won, the Grandmaster would grant him the power of life and death. If Kang lost, the Grandmaster would just kind of obliterate all life on Earth. Both Kang and the Grandmaster had chosen human pawns to use in this game of galaxies. Kang selected the Avengers, while the Grandmaster created a group called the Squadron Sinister. You see, the Grandmaster's home planet is filled with living computers that can do just about anything he wants them to, including, for these purposes, conjuring up superpowered bad guys. What followed was the first part of the game, in which the Avengers battled the Squadron in four separate contests. Due to the unexpected interference of the Black Knight in one of these contests, it was determined that the first round was just a stalemate. In the second round, three of the Avengers were sent back to the 1940s to battle the original versions of Captain America, the Submariner, and the Human Torch. Kang's team won this battle eventually. Because he had won only half of the game, the Grandmaster made Kang choose: power over life or power over death. Despite his desire to bring Ravonna back to life, Kang's hatred overcame him, and he chose the ability to bring death to the Avengers. But by phrasing it in that way, he kinda sealed his doom, as the Black Knight showed up again, and because he was not an Avenger, defeated Kang. So, with a wave of his hand, the Grandmaster departed in search of other stuff to play. Fast forward to 1978, and another Avengers foe, the Collector, revealed that he was part of a group known as the Elders of the Universe, and that the Grandmaster was also a member of this elusive club of immensely powerful and incredibly old beings. After the Collector had been killed, the Grandmaster arranged one of his high-stakes games with Death herself in order to try to bring his, quote, brother back to life. A few years after that, the Grandmaster revealed that he and his so-called brothers were actually the last remaining survivors of various ancient races. The key to their long lives was that each had a massive obsession with one thing which kept them alive. The Collector collected things, the Grandmaster got off on gambling. By the way, that's totally how immortality works.
Power! Destruction! This game has everything!
Other than what we've said above, there's not really much that's known about the Grandmaster's origins. But that really hasn't stopped him from bringing his gamesmanship to other media. He's made his mark in a number of Marvel's animated TV offerings, not to mention Jeff Goldblum's cinematic take on the character. On the page or on the screen, he's definitely a player.
What have you brought today? Tell me.
A contender.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out these other great clips from WatchMojo and subscribe for new videos every day.